الحمد لله، الحمد لله الخبير الحكيم، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الواحد القوي المتين، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله صادق الوعد الأمين. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اتبعه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فيا عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله، فقد فاز من اتقى وخاب من عصى. Blessed Friday جماعة رحمكم الله. Let us strengthen our taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by fulfilling His commands and living His prohibitions. Taqwa is not merely a verbal expression. It has to be proven through good deeds that are done sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same goes for our pledge that we recite at the beginning of every prayer. It was a prayer and also the divine words of God as captured in Surah Al-An'am, verse 162. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين. The meaning: say, indeed my prayer, my rites or sacrifice, my living and my dying are for Allah, Lord of the worlds. This is a sacred and holy pledge. Each mu'min who utters it is declaring his certitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This pledge is not just to be read or memorized, but it needs to be appreciated, understood, and accomplish in our daily life. My brothers, rahimahullah, soon we will be honoring the event of Isra and Mi'raj yet again. It is an event that tells us the story of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's journey from Mecca to Masjid al-Aqsa and from Masjid al-Aqsa to Sidratul Muntaha. Therefore, to commemorate this holy event, our khutbah for this week aims to give us reminders and guidelines on the importance of examining the goals and objectives of our lives, which ultimately should be a means of attaining happiness and success in the hereafter. My dear brothers, rahimahullah, I would like to share with all of you a Quranic verse on the success of the akhirah. I feel that it's a verse which brings a profound meaning that we all have to observe. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِالْقَلْبِ سَلِيمٍ, which means the day when wealth or children will not benefit anyone except for the one who comes to Allah with a sound heart. Surah Ash-Shu'ara, verses 88 to 89. My dear brothers, in the verses which have just been recited to you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a picture of the Akhirah, the day of judgment, the day when position, wealth, fortune, and all the pleasures of life that we have attained will not bring us any benefit before God, except for the one who comes before Allah with a pure and sound heart. Subhanallah. My brothers, this is how important it is to have a pure heart. There is a dua that was constantly recited by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is also a prayer that asks for purity and soundness of the heart. Narrated from Shahab bin Aus, the following dua vasıta to us by Rasulullah sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem. وأسألك الله وأسألك شكر نعمتك وحسن عبادتك وأسألك لسانا صادقا وقلبا سليما. This dua means, and I ask you, O Allah, to grant me gratitude for your blessings and perfection for my ibadah to you, and I ask you for an honest tongue and a sound heart. Reported by Imam Ahmad rahimahullah. Just imagine, my dear brothers, the person who always reciting this dua, he was ma'soom, a person is protected from committing sins, a person whose heart was full of good, of mercy, of compassion. How about us? Surely we are the ones who need to utter this dua and recite even more. Dear brothers, rahimahumullah, the importance of the purity of the heart cannot be denied. Based on this belief, Imam Al-Ghazali stated that if a person knows his heart, he will know his true self, and this will motivate and encourage him to know God. However, if a person does not know his own heart, then he will not identify himself, and this will lead him away from God. Imam Al-Ghazali then concluded by saying that a lot of human beings do not know their own hearts. That is the reality. Also, purity and soundness of the heart is something necessary for each of us to attain. The heart itself is unfortunately an organ that is often neglected by humankind. We take care of our health by consuming healthy, nutritious food. We take care of our bodies and ensure that they remain active and healthy through exercise. However, my dear brothers, how about our efforts to cleanse and purify our hearts? Do we leave our hearts without tending to them? How can a mu'min who yearns for his well-being in the hereafter not working hard to ensure his heart is pure and sound? I would like to share with you a couple of advice from the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that can serve as guidelines for us to attain pure hearts for the sake of our success in the hereafter, akhirah. Firstly, safeguarding the heart by guarding the tongue. One prophetic guide for a mu'min who wants to take care of his heart is to watch what his tongue utters. If the heart is sound, inshallah, the tongue will speak the right things and vice versa. Based on this principle, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam emphasized in the hadith reported by Imam Ahmad, "La yastaqimu imanu 'abdin hatta yastaqima qalbu, wa la yastaqimu qalbu hatta yastaqima lisanu." Which means the faith of a servant is not upright until his heart is upright, and his heart is not upright until his tongue is upright. We yearn for our faith to be stable. We hope for our hearts to be wholesome. So we must internalize this advice by the Prophet by taking care of what our tongues utter. In fact, given that the social media is a significant part of our daily lives, guarding our tongues is no longer limited to verbal speech, but should also include what we write on social media. If it is good, then it will have a good outcome. But if it is not, then unfortunately, it is only a reflection of our hearts. Secondly, my dear brothers, being open to feedback for self-improvement. This is a crucial advice, my dear brothers. Many of our faults and flaws are seen by the people around us, and we usually cannot spot our own failings. We speak of pure hearts, of great character and conduct, without realizing there are many areas of ourselves that we need to work on to improve. Let us reflect upon what Rasulullah SAW said in the hadith, which means that a mu'min is the reflection of his mu'min brother, reported by At-Tabarani. Why? Why did the Prophet ﷺ say that the relationship between mu'mins is like a mirror? My brothers, we use the mirror daily to see if there is anything we want to fix or whether there are additional grooming and tidying needed. Such is the role of a mu'min when it comes to his brothers in faith. He not only praises and commends his brother, but he will share his opinions and suggestions when it comes to any shortcomings that are observed, and if there is any improvement that should be done. Therefore, my dear brothers, through consistent mutual feedback, it is easier for a mu'min to attain a better, higher level of himself, to build and shape good character and a pure heart. Let us pray for and work towards Allah's acceptance of all our good deeds and ibadah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the strength to continue doing good deeds, and may He bestow upon us the goodness of the world and the hereafter, and may He include us from amongst His righteous servants. Ameen. Ya Rabbil Alameen. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Rahim. ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم وتقبل مني ومنكم تلاوته إنه هو السميع العليم أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات فاستغفروا فيا فوز المستغفرين ويا نجاة التائبين.